somebody to play with me later, but we're just sort of decided to come over here and try out a bunch of music and collaborate together. Kai Welch, who you're going to see play later.
Yeah. About audiences, I mean, when you were doing this, I assume, obviously a huge expat audience in Beijing who are going to go, see this thing. That's probably your primary target audience in a certain way. But what about the Chinese audiences? They may have a jumping off point for the music in a certain way.
What I think is interesting about these guys, I mean, on the one hand, the first shows that, or the two concerts that Abigail and the Sparrow Quartet did at Beijing University.
Yeah.
I have been doing a jazz series there since, actually, the first version of Abigail's Sparrow Quartet that became Sparrow Quartet played first at Beijing University in my jazz series. Mm-hmm. That was the first gig of our series, so it's 4 years old now. And what's great about that is that these university students, primarily university students, in this theater with 2,000 seats, I mean, even though they have a couple big names on their bill, it's not the kind of place that you would probably necessarily play at home.
Yeah,
maybe
a theater
like that. Or maybe it is.
That is, yeah.
It's totally.
Totally.
Yeah. What I love about the series is that these students are hungry for music.
Oh, yeah.
When we came in there to try and do a jazz series with the idea, the theater said, well, jazz music has drums. And I said,
yes.
Yes, it does. You're right. Well, if it has drums, maybe it'll be loud. And if it's loud, maybe it'll be too much for the kids. And then we'll have, a situation.
Yeah,
nobody really goes into what these situations are.
Right.
But anyway, the other, another two things that are from a similar place is jazz music is music that's played in smoky underground bars.
Right.
And we are a theater of higher quality than that. The other arm is jazz music is too high class and nobody understands it.
Mm-hmm.
What I found, the nice thing is we started with folk music, for one, which is a nice crossover, especially their folk music, which has a lot of jazz elements in it because of the players that are in their group.
Right.
But
eclectic is a good word for it.
And also the thing about folk music is that you can see that it's familiar to people.
Yeah.
Regardless of where you're from.
Yeah.
But particularly like American folk music, when Americans hear it who have never heard some of their songs, I think it really rings familiar.
Yeah.
And I think that what we've discovered through Abigail going around the country actually is that different folk music folks fit in very well with the idea of folk music.
That's
from Kazakh minorities to Mongolian minorities to
Tibetan
minorities to, the Han sort of tradition and stuff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so you see the reaction of the students, in particular at Beijing University Theater, where it's a 2,000-seat theater and there's probably 90% of them are either Beijing University students or the students around the neighborhood. And I've seen that with the folk music, but also with pretty out there jazz as well that
they're
we've presented
to
in there.
To
and
to
they really,
to it.
Yeah, I mean, what they do is they feed off of the performance, and I think that that's something that a lot of, because they're used to these classical, very staid performances where the performers are just sort of the method by which the music gets played, as opposed to people actually doing a performance that you can tell is part of an interaction with folks. And so I think these students, they don't get a lot of opportunities to see different kinds of music.
Yeah.
They get an opportunity to see a lot of similar kinds of music in the classical realm and theater and stuff like this. But to get sort of live musicians that play both in the club setting and in the theater setting.
Yeah.
I think it's really interesting to the journey of trying to figure out how to get in front of different Chinese audiences, because there's such a different mentality as a fan here or as a music appreciator.
Mm-hmm.
There's either the extreme of being a pop music lover, or there's hardly anything else, with the exception of a very sort of specific group of people who identify with something alternative, which, or there's what you're talking about, which is what people are sort of encouraged to enjoy, which is the classical tradition or the theater traditions and things like that.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it is hard to find a space where you can draw a lot of people that are interested in alternative recurring visits of a certain kind of musician from around the world, or even local.
Right.
You know.
Right.
So I'm enjoying being a part of that exploration.
Yeah.
And I do feel like in the next 10, 15 years that things are going to expand huge in that area.
I guess when you